Biathlon has produced some outstanding competition in this Universiade, in the men's and in the women's events. This was the last day of competition, the men finishing up with the 15-kilometre mass start. Conditions, a touch cloudy, but the competition sure to be hot. The Russians have already picked up three golds, including a mixed relay. They were looking to Sergei Kyachin, Dmitry Elkin and Alexei Kornev to bring in another one. But it was a Serb who led the 29 skiers to the first intermediate point. Milanko Petrovic, winner of the 10K sprint, closely followed by the Ukrainian Dmitry Podrushny and the Czech Vityanov. It was another Ukrainian, Dmitry Rusinov, who led them to the first shooting note. The Slovakian Martin Achenas and the Czech Tomas Krupčič beginning to emerge. Podrushny shooting clean, but Petrov missing two. For the men to emerge in front from the first shooting, the German Alexander Kiefer, then Podrushny and Tomas Krupčič. At the second intermediate at the 4.8-kilometre mark, it was the same three, although the order had changed a tad. Podrushny now in front, with Krupčič into second and Kiefer now third, but a second separating the three of them. Onto the second shooting, this trio settling down, although some problems on the range. Kiefer missing once and Tomas Krupčič twice. Those misses mean penalty loops and the chance for the others to do some catching up. Kiefer, a student at Furtwängen University, and Podrushny still leading, while Tomas Krupčič emerged from his two loops, still in third, but only just and a long way behind the leaders, 27 seconds behind. Podrushny already with a successful game. Silver in the mixed relay and bronze in the 10K sprint, but no gold as yet. At the third intermediate point, that was beginning to look more likely. The Ukrainian with a 5-second lead over Kiefer, who was beginning to feel the pace. The German, having only come 28th and 30th in his two previous events, really being tested. Tomas Krupčič still in third, but 25 seconds back. Andrei Kornev now up into fourth. The effects of fatigue in the biathlon don't just affect your speed over the snow. With the heart rate pumping, it can become more difficult to control the rifle. Podrushny with a mistake on the range at the third shooting, but Kiefer missed twice, and that was the end of the German challenge. Podrushny emerging still in the lead, 16 seconds clear of Kornev. And into third now, not Tomas Krupčič, but his younger brother, Matej. Well, Podrushny now beginning to put on the burners, opening up a big gap ahead of the chasers. The 22-year-old arriving at the 10.8-kilometre intermediate point, 27 seconds ahead of Kornev, struggling to hold off Krupčič, a member of the Czech team that won bronze in the mixed relay. Podrushny first to the final shooting and the first away, clean on the range, and now the gold medal dangling invitingly for him. Kornev missing one of his shots, but Tomas Krupčič went clean, as did Matej. Dmitry Elkin also shooting clean to give himself a chance of a medal. Podrushny leaving the range with a 40-second lead over Tomas Krupčič, his brother just 3 seconds behind. Podrushny totally in control at this last intermediate point. He's heading for his first gold of the games. Matej Krupčič has slipped back, but Tomas is still there battling Elkin for the silver. Podrushny all on his own, a great moment for him, collecting the Ukrainian flag, crossing the line for gold in a time of 39.00.8. The sprint is on for second. Tomas Krupčič too quick, too strong for Elkin. They take silver and bronze. Disappointment for Matej Krupčič, the younger of the brothers, finishing in fourth and out of the medals, but a great day for that man, Dmytro Podrushny. He takes gold, Tomas Krupčič takes the silver, and Elkin takes the bronze.